Hey y'all, Chuck here. Well, this morning we're getting ready, packing up from camp and going to get on a plane and fly to Chicago. We'll be there, I think by 2 o'clock today. That ought to be entertaining. So like I said in my last video, we got to go there to get Paige's Thai passport renewed, and that's the easiest place to go. So I've got to secure the campsite, you know, while we're gone. I'm gonna have to take this down because I don't, you know, the wind might blow. You don't ever want to leave that canopy up in the air, really, when you're gone, when you're running, just in case it catches wind. So I bought some little chili pepper lights. I asked Paige, I said, hey, what kind of lights do you want for the trailer? She goes, chili pepper lights, like it was some kind of joke. I was like, okay, fine. So I got on eBay and I found these. So I was like, bam, what? You think I can do it? What's next? So anyway, they're pretty cool. We sat out here last night and had a couple cocktails and sat underneath the chili peppers. So I'm gonna secure these. I stow these down in my little storage container here. I got a little box I keep everything in. Try to keep everything nice and neat as much as possible. So, hey, you know what? We've got a problem with flies. I'm sure everybody's got a problem with flies when they're camping. I gotta find something to get rid of the damn flies. I'm gonna make a little, the CDs. I'm gonna make a little deal on some fishing little leaders, and I'll show you that crap later, but I bought this. I mean, there's flies everywhere. This thing right here, this fly strip, I caught a couple flies. Not many, just a couple flies. But it was outside where there was a shitload of flies. I bought this, I put this thing in my damn house and the trailer, I mean, throw that shit away. And it didn't work. I didn't catch no flies. So I don't know if the attractant is not good enough on those fly strips, or they make something better, or I need to smear something on it to make them more attractive to it. So yeah, I need to put this canopy up and drain my tanks. What's wrong?
Green spider.
A what?
A green spider.
A green spider?
Yeah.
Just kick it.
Okay. I need it.
You gonna put a dent in my truck?
Yeah.
Okay, just hit the button. Spider. The spider saga continues. So I've kind of mastered this thing here a little bit. It's really pretty easy to do. Only a few steps. You gotta let these down all the way. Well, not all the way yet. Do one down a little bit. You want to knock off the leaves. You don't want to roll it up with debris inside there. Loosen these locks up right here. I don't know if y'all's are different than mine, but this is how I do mine. Take this. Then you grab your little rope. Hang on, babe. Hang on. Hang on.
Oh.
You can't open the door while I'm doing this. Okay. So, what the hell did I do here? Okay, this isn't all the way down. Son of a bitch. So there's a mistake. I didn't let that thing fall all the way down. So now I'm gonna have to release that. Pull it out a little bit. Yeah. Hell, it is all the way down. This ain't all the way down. Okay. Technical difficulty. But I'll overcome it. That's it. Done. So, that's up. These little things right here just kind of pop. Right here, they kind of just pop in place. And then, this one just kind of pop it in place, and that keeps it from coming out. So we got that secured. Oh, I gotta stow all my chairs and my fan. We're gonna be gone for 3 days there in Chicago, so I want to make sure I don't think anybody's gonna steal it where we're at, but I'm gonna stow it anyway. You never know, the weather's so unpredictable. I don't want to be picking it up in somebody's yard. I'm just going to set it in. Yeah. I definitely need to reorganize that better. I've got that gigantic truck that's become my garage now, but I'm going to organize stuff between the garage and the little stove bin a little bit better, so when we're camping, I want to get all of our outdoor stuff to be in there, you know, our little picnic area. But I have this big ass outdoor table, this camping table. It folds up pretty good, but I probably have to keep that in my truck. I got this fan. Maybe I'll just put this fan in the trailer for now. Yeah. You know, I guess a lot of things I can put in my trailer too when we're traveling. We're not gonna be traveling in the friggin' trailer, so I might be able to quickly, you know, set stuff in here and secure it. And then when we get to the campsite, just take it out and set up the trailer and then set up the outdoor campsite. I guess the only problem would be if it's raining when we get there. I don't know. I don't see that that's going to really be a problem anyway, but I need to empty the doo-doo station. Oh, shit. I bought this chair to get in and out of my, in and out of the back of my truck. The truck's a four-wheel drive, so it's a little tall. It's okay to get in, it's just hard to get out of the damn thing. So I'm gonna go back here and attempt to try to skip my shit. Sorry, camera tight fit. I bought this elbow. I don't know if you can see that or not. Shit. So it's a clear elbow, and I bought that so that I can, not that I want to watch doo-doo, but I know pretty much when my gray tank is empty, I can see, because I have the darker elbow, but all I can do is hear, you know, the sounds of the water stop. But with the clear one, I know when it's empty. So right now I'm opening my black tank. I know from all my subscribers telling me, I know you gotta open the black tank first. So my black tank gets open first, so that all the hard stuff, the bathroom, the toilet stuff comes out. And then I'm gonna open the gray tank, which is the shower water, and the sink water last, and that'll help flush out my hose. So I realize that. So when I'm done with this, open up my gray, then I'm gonna go add about maybe a gallon or two of water in the toilet, and then I'm gonna add my chemical in there so when we get back from Chicago, it doesn't smell like shit. So my gray tank is stopped. I'm sorry, my black tank. I don't know why I keep saying gray, but maybe because the handle here is gray and it doesn't say black, but the other handle's black, but it says gray. Does that make sense? Anyway, I get confused. I'm easily confused, but I catch on fast. So I'm going to go inside and add a little bit of water into my toilet. And then add some chemical in there. I'm not gonna bore you with that crap. And then, you know, one thing I have to do here, because I, you know, the way I had to park my trailer and the property, I wanted to have the sewage dump on the other side, but it just didn't work out that way. So I have to, you always gotta kind of MacGyver your toilet situation. So I'm sure I'll probably have to buy more shit for later. But one thing is that it kind of ends up on the ground right here, and I'm gonna have to pick it up to get the water out, you know, to flow into the septic. So ain't no big deal. But anyway, you always got to kind of buy toilet stuff, you know. Or I don't know, on the way maybe I'll realize I don't need to hook up everywhere. We just hook up on the way out, and you know, and everything will be fine. So I don't know yet. Still an adventure, still a learning experience, I should say. And just bring it here, I'll say. Yeah, so we've got everything secure in the trailer. I just turned the hot water off. I don't want to leave the hot water heater on while we're gone for 3 days. What the hell? So, yeah. I don't like airplanes. I don't like airports, I should say. And I like campers better than I do transients. I guess we're all transients, but I like campers better than I do like people fly. I don't know. It's just a different atmosphere, I guess. I don't know. It's just different. So, yeah, we're getting ready to go. Got about an hour drive to the airport. Okay. And, yeah, so we haven't eaten breakfast yet, so we got to get to the airport and get some breakfast. Let me put my bag. Okay, well, we're off. We're actually running a little late, I guess.
Dang.
Probably not. I think it takes about an hour to get to the airport. It's 9 o'clock right now. Our plane boards at 11. So we'd like to get to the airport, just like probably everybody else, about an hour early. It is Wednesday, so I don't think there's going to be too many commuters today at the airport, but you never know. So we haven't eaten, so I'm going to get really irritated soon if we don't eat. So I think we need to get into the airport, get some weed. Well, first, we got to go drop the car off at the shuttle. Drop the car off and then get on a shuttle bus. At the, you know, we park our car in a little parking place. So one more thing I forgot to mention about the trailer is I did shut off the hot water heater. I turned that off, and I turned off the water. I left it plugged into the electricity. You know, I don't want to run down my battery, but which I'm not sure is good. I got to check that still. So I just, the only thing I did was I turned off all the utilities, and I left it plugged in, turned off all the hot water heater, and then I turned off the water going to the trailer, just in case there's a pipe bust or something. I don't think you should leave your water on while you're gone, while you're camping. I mean, while you're sightseeing, I think you should turn all your stuff off. It doesn't take long for the hot water heater to heat up a little 6-gallon tank. So, but anyway, we're off. Hopefully there's no traffic, right?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, it'll be fine. Yay, we made it to the airport shuttle. No traffic. 40 minutes. I just drove behind a bunch of lunatics.
One last song. Yes.
Got here pretty quick, so
we'll
be at the airport probably in about 5 minutes. American Airlines. Check in our luggage, find some food, get on the plane. Boring. This is boring stuff for me. Anyway, I'll take y'all along anyway. We'll go see some stuff in Chicago.
It's gonna be raining.
Yeah, it's gonna be raining.
Thunder.
It's always raining.
See.
Always raining. Well, we made it through security here at the airport, so it wasn't too bad. Pretty easy. Of course, it is a Wednesday, so not a whole lot of people here. So. When I walk into here, the first thing I see is margarita. Is it too early for margarita? It's only 10. Anyway, we gotta find some food. Is there food where we're going over here? Okay, we gotta find the El Baño and find food. Yay, so we found some breakfast. Airport breakfast. They had the bathroom closed because they were cleaning it, so we had to walk a little ways to go to the bathroom, and I go in there and there's a lady in there. I'm like, okay, maybe I'm in the wrong spot. Because, you know, the laws have changed. So you never know. So I go out and look, yeah, it's the men's. So I'm like, okay. So this guy walks in there and he comes out. I said, you never know. I said, it doesn't matter to me. I could care less. And if you want to spectate, I don't care. But he went in there with his little boy and I felt sorry for the guy. So anyway, adventure begins. Well, we're just sitting here in the terminal. It's not ours. Waiting for the plane. So my wife bought me 2 pairs of hiking shoes.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
These Merrell.
Yeah. Right. And then we can
Merrell hiking. You got some too, right? Yeah.
Mine's green.
Of course Paige has the colorful ones. They're really comfortable. Really comfortable. I've been working out in the yard with the other ones, so they're pretty dirty, but they clean up really good. So but they're comfortable. They're about $100. About $120, but they're well worth it. I really like it. I really like them a lot. So anyway, I'm bored. I'd much rather travel with RV people instead of airport people. I guess, you know, my kids grew up and left the house a few years ago, so now I'm like, when I'm around other people's kids, I start getting a little shaky, so I feel like I'm becoming allergic to small children. Maybe it's not the children more than it is the parents, so I don't know, I never let my kids run around and act stupid. And, you know, now that I'm retired, I guess sometimes not all working people, but you know, people walk around talking about how they're gonna, you know, I don't know, they're talking about their job, I guess, you know, how they're gonna mail their presentation, how they're gonna propose their business proposal, or how they're gonna do something, blah 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 blah. I'm just like, really, I don't know, I'm tired of hearing about it. So. Yeah. Anyway, I'm just rambling on, I guess. So, waiting for the plane. Oh, we made it on our little bitty plane.
Mm-hmm.
So, we just confirmed something.
What?
That we thought Paige was just hitting herself in the head and her elbows because our travel trailer was too small. She smashed her head right there. She did it. I'm just going to buy her a helmet. Helmet, maybe some elbow pads.
Yeah.
Okay. 2.5-hour flight.
So.
rental. Trying to find our baggage. And then we gotta find our rental car place. Don't step on that. I don't know what that is. Somebody pooped there. So, yeah. Flight wasn't too bad. It's all good so far. Okay, well, we're here. We got the rental car. We got a little Camry, I think. It's a Camry? Yeah, and we're at the hotel. This is a Best Western. So, this whole trip was pretty cheap, actually. I think Paige got it for $620 for two round trip tickets and hotel for two nights. So the rental car, I don't think they want you to rent cars here because that was the most expensive. That was what, $60? Yeah, $60 a day. So it cost $120 for the damn car. And
Not more.
3 days. Oh, 3 days. Yeah, 3 days. So yeah, we spent almost as much on the damn car as we did on the whole trip. So. Chicago has an awesome transit system here, but my problem is I don't like to depend on people. So I decided to shit. I drove all the way in the back and the lady probably thought, why the hell is it going back there? This thing better work here. Let's see. Ditch ass. Great, I'm retarded, so. I parked all the way to the back to get out of the way. So we can't go into the back, so I gotta load all the shit back up, excuse my language, and then drive back around to the front so I can look at the lady at the desk. So I told you it was right there, but anyway, I'm a little different, so.
Maybe it's not
safe. Yeah, it might not be safe, so. All right. Okay, let's try this again. Just walk into the front. Walk into the entrance and the only way into the facility. We've got our room. So, yeah. We took a tour. See,
restroom.
I'm all the way down here at the end where we were, right here. Okay, let's see if I can get into our room with this thing. Maybe the key don't work. Oh my God.
Why do you have so many things?
I have a lot of things going on right now. It worked. Enter. Smells clean. Not bad for the price. Best Western, Chicago O'Hare Airport. And $620. As long as they don't get robbed, everything's great. Mm-hmm. All right, we're gonna have to find food. So I went down to the lobby to try to find some things to do. I grabbed a bunch of this stuff, so we're. I know we're gonna go to the museum. I think tomorrow or Thursday. I don't know. We might go right after we go to the Thai embassy.
Yeah. And then.
Today's Wednesday. Is it
Wednesday.
So we have. It's 3 o'clock right now. We have all day tomorrow and all day Friday because our plane doesn't take off till late. We don't get back home to Houston till like midnight. So. And we're gonna find something to do. Okay, well, I resorted to Google Maps. and found a restaurant, an Italian restaurant that's supposed to be kind of lively, some dancing stuff. It's only 4:30, but I'm starving to death, and I really don't feel like trying to drive downtown right now, after, you know, traffic hours. So we're gonna do all that tomorrow, and tonight we're just gonna go grab some food, maybe hit a little pub and a local pub somewhere close to the hotel, and then go to bed, get up early, and then head to the embassy, try to get there early so we could have a full day downtown. Yeah. Tomorrow, and then we'll wake up Friday, maybe go back downtown and take some boat rides. Okay. I forgot my hair gel again. So I'm trying to find the traveling. I think I found it, traveling section. Actually, no, I didn't. So I'm in a Walgreens. I thought I saw it right there, but it's not. So feel like I need to have hair gel for whatever reason. So anyway, at a Walgreens, trying to find hair gel. Can't seem to find it. I'm always lost in Walgreens. I don't understand why. It's not very big. Okay. I found it, but I don't really like this kind. Not that I'm picky or anything. But. Okay, let's get some water. We actually came here for water, for bottled water for the room. We're just looking. Mm-hmm. We're looking right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's go. You want a big one?
I don't want the, what big one? Where, all that. Oh yeah, I guess I could. Like stick it in my bag. Oh well, I found this. This is like travel trailer size stuff right here. So actually, Paige found it. Got to be spiked up. That's what I need right there. I got to be spiked up. Okay. Well, we have arrived to this place called Tuscanese Italian Restaurant.
Italian.
So we're gonna go in here and check it out. It's a lot of traffic, of course. It's in Chicago, and everybody's coming home from work. So we're in a little town called Schiller Park. Little town. Just I think it's west of downtown Chicago. So. Anyway, let's go check out the food. So, cool place, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty cool. Looks okay to me. I don't care, I'm not picky. I know there's some good Italian food here in Chicago, so check it out.
It's good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to be good. You want Italian? Are you gonna get a pizza? Chicago style pizzas are huge. I told the waiter I wanted a grown-up drink, and he looked at me like I was retarded. So I guess they don't have a lot of sense of humor. So I got me a scotch and a club soda. I'm trying to figure out what we want. How's that?
Crunchy.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's me and Paige and my three other people in here. We still, I'm not going to complain this whole video, I promise. But I just think it's funny sometimes. We're in no big hurry, we got nowhere to go. Our menus are still sitting on the table. We've been here about 10 minutes. They don't have Grey Goose vodka. Paige wanted them. They don't have the beer that you like, so. It's okay though, but she just got a Grey Goose and vodka. They don't have Grey Goose, but they have Tito's, which is odd because Tito's is made in Texas, but no Grey Goose. But I think I'm staring at a Grey Goose bottle over there, but it's okay. I got a double Dewar's and club soda.
Okay. What is it? Fettuccine Alfredo?
With chicken.
With chicken. soup or salad, it's minestrone, escargot, chicken or a hot salad. Italian, French, ranch, blue cheese, creamy garlic.
Ranch.
I'll have the half chicken, rotisserie chicken, which takes a little bit longer. It's just
we're not in a hurry.
Okay. Okay.
And ranch, so
ranch. Okay.
Thank you. I don't think they're in a big hurry here anyway to do anything. We actually got nothing to do. I just think it's comical sometimes. We're supposed, this is a relaxed. This was supposed to actually be like a pretty outgoing place with dancers. That's what the. But it's still early. It probably doesn't happen until like 6. I don't think they're going to start dancing around for two of us. So. Anyway, I hope you're not bored yet. I don't know. This is just what's happening in our day. So. Anyway, going to wait here for our food. And, our food's arrived. It actually looks pretty good. Looks beautiful. So. Well, we just stumbled onto a little roadside. Pub called the Hop
Video Slot
Scotch.
Okay.
Pub.
Did it? I want to pee.
So, yeah, I'm here. I think. So yeah, there's like nobody in Chicago. Mm-hmm. We're the only people here. Again.
Too early. It's weekday.
We're at a place called. Hopscotch.
Yeah.
Happy birthday. So yeah, so there's not a whole lot of Mexican beer. He dug out like a canned Modelo out of the cooler, but that was it. So another I got a Chevis and Club Soda, and she got a
Purple Haze.
A Purple Haze with a lime. Is it good? It's fruity with a twist of lime. So yeah. Anyway, we're just gonna sit here and chill and have a couple drinks. Go back to the hotel. Get up early in the morning and go do what we need to do, what we came here for. And just whatever comes next. Somebody's yard. I'm just gonna set it in. I definitely need to reorganize that better. I've got that gigantic truck that's become my garage now, so but I'm gonna organize stuff between the garage and the little stove in a little bit better, so when we're camping I want to get all of our outdoor stuff to be in there, you know, our little picnic area. But I have this big ass outdoor table. This camping table, it folds up pretty good, but I probably have to keep that in my truck. So I got this fan. Maybe I'll just put this fan in the trailer for now. Yeah. You know, I guess a lot of things I can put in my trailer too when we're traveling. We're not gonna be traveling in the friggin' trailer, so I might be able to quickly, you know, set stuff in here and secure it. And then when we get to the campsite, just take it out and set up the trailer and then set up the outdoor campsite. I guess the only problem would be if it's raining when we get there. I don't know. I don't see that that's going to really be a problem. anyway, but I need to empty the doo-doo station. Oh shit. This, I bought this chair to get in and out of my, in and out of the back of my truck. The truck's a four-wheel drive, so it's a little tall. It's okay to get in, it's just hard to get out of the damn thing. So I'm gonna go back here and attempt to try to skip my, sorry, camera, tight fit. I bought this elbow. I bought this. I mean, there's flies everywhere. This thing right here, this fly strip, I caught a couple flies. Not many, just a couple flies. But it was outside where there was a shitload of flies. I bought this, I put this thing in my damn house, and the trailer, I mean, throw that shit away. And it didn't work. I didn't catch no flies, so. I don't know if they're, the attractant is not good enough on those fly strips, or they make something better. Or I need to smear something on it to make them more attractive to it. So yeah. I need to put this canopy up and drain my tanks. What's wrong?
Green spider.
A what?
A green spider.
A green spider?
Yeah, yeah.
Just kick it.
Okay. I need it.
You gonna put a dent in my truck?
Yeah.
Okay, just hit the button. Spider. The spider saga continues. So I've kind of mastered this thing here a little bit. It's really pretty easy to do. Only a few steps. You gotta let these down all the way. Well, not all the way yet. Do one down a little bit. You want to knock off the leaves. You don't want to roll it up with debris inside there. Loosen these locks up right here. I don't know if y'all's are different than mine, but this is how I do mine. Take this. Hey y'all, Chuck here. Hey y'all, Chuck here. Well, this morning we're getting ready, packing up from camp and going to get on a plane and fly to Chicago. We'll be there, I think, by 2 o'clock today. That ought to be entertaining. So like I said in my last video, we got to go there to get Paige's Thai passport renewed, and that's the easiest place to go. So I've got to secure the campsite, you know, while we're gone. I'm gonna have to take this down because I don't, you know, the wind might blow. You don't ever want to leave that canopy up in the air, really, when you're gone, when you're running, just in case it catches wind. So I bought some little chili pepper lights. I asked Paige, I said, hey, what kind of lights do you want for the trailer? She goes, chili pepper lights. Like it was some kind of joke. It's like, okay, fine. So I got on eBay and I found these. So I was like, bam, what? You think I can do it? What's next? So anyway, they're pretty cool. We sat out here last night and had a couple cocktails and sat underneath the chili peppers. So I'm gonna secure these. I stow these down in my little storage container here. I got a little box I keep everything in. Try to keep everything nice and neat as much as possible. So hey, you know what, we've got a problem with flies. I'm sure everybody's got a problem with flies when they're camping. I gotta find something to get rid of the damn flies. I'm gonna make a little, the the CDs. I'm gonna make a little deal on some fishing little leaders, and I'll show you that crap later, but I don't know if you can see that or not. Shit. So it's a clear elbow, and I bought that so that I can, not that I want to watch doo-doo, but I know whenever, I know pretty much when my gray tank is empty, I can see. Because when I have the darker elbow, and but all I can do is hear, you know, the sounds of the water stop. But with the clear one, I know when it's empty. So right now I'm opening my black tank. I know from all my subscribers telling me, I know you got to open the black tank first. So my black tank gets open first, so that all the hard stuff, the bathroom, the toilet stuff comes out, and then I'm gonna open the gray tank, which is the shower water and the sink water last, and that'll help flush out my hose. So I realize that. So when I'm done with this, open up my gray, then I'm gonna go add about maybe a gallon or two of water in the toilet, and then I'm gonna add my chemical in there, so when we get back from Chicago, it doesn't smell like shit. So my gray tank is stopped. I'm sorry, my black tank. I don't know why I keep saying gray, because maybe because the handle here is gray and it doesn't say black, but the other handle's black, but it says gray. Does that make sense? Anyway, I get confused. I'm easily confused, but I catch on fast. So I'm going to go inside and add a little bit of water into my toilet, and then add some chemical in there. I'm not gonna bore you with that crap. And then, you know, one thing I have to do here. And that's it. Then you grab your little rope. Hang on, babe, hang on. Hang on. I can't open the door while I'm doing this. Okay. So, what the hell did I do here? Okay, this isn't all the way down. Son of a bitch. So there's a mistake. I didn't let that thing fall all the way down. So now I'm going to have to release that. Pull it out a little bit. Yeah. Hell, it is all the way down. This ain't all the way down. Okay. Technical difficulty. But I'll overcome it. That's it. Done. So, that's up. These little things right here just kind of pop right here. They kind of just pop in place. And then this one just kind of pop it in place. And that keeps it from coming out. So we got that secured. Oh, I got to stow all my chairs and my fan. We're gonna be gone for 3 days there in Chicago, so I want to make sure I don't think anybody's gonna steal it where we're at, but I'm gonna stow it anyway in case we have. So you never know, the weather's so unpredictable. I don't want to be picking it up.